Hey y'all, happy Friday. I'm so glad that you guys are joining us tonight. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kim Kellogg and I am the creative force behind Lilac Lane DIY, where we hope to get you creative and keep you creative by doing all these fun projects on live nights, which are Wednesdays and Fridays. Hey mom, so we've got two really cool projects tonight. And the first one is a shadow box, a chicken wire shadow box. Super, super cool. I can't wait to put this one all together for you. And the next one is a bee door hanger or sign, whatever you want to do with it. You don't always have to put them on the door. You can hang them inside the house as well. So we've got a lot to do tonight, but I want to show you some cool things that we've already been working on for the week. So we made these amazing, hey Sarita, hey Donna, these amazing keychains. And I know I won't be able to show you the right way because, again, I am trying. I keep trying and it won't turn it around. These keychains say raising. This mom is raising kind humans. Super, super cute. So there's three different designs. This mom is raising a kind human and raising kind humans. So you can get them either single or plural, depending on whether you have one or more children. Super cute. These are gonna be available next week, and they are $6 a piece with the key ring attached. So I'm gonna have those posted later on and you'll be able to choose the ones that you want. I think that's a great gift for somebody. Also this weekend, we've got some fun classes and we do have a few seats left in both classes if you're interested. First is this welcome with the crab or the welcome with the starfish. Both are adorable. And, which everybody's been talking about, we've had some people pick it up as a kit already, the ocean wave heart. I love it. This is gorgeous and, of course, huge. We showed this the other night. Hey, Holly. Oh, you are so welcome. I'm glad I was able to do that for you. That was an easy fix, girl. So those are the projects that we have this weekend. So if you're interested in any of those, like I said, we do have a couple seats left for both of those classes. We also have all kinds of other fun stuff going on this weekend. We have a book signing with our friend Sharon from 2 to 4 on Saturday. So if you're friends with Sharon, make sure you stop by and see her. You know, she doesn't come to visit us that often anymore because she's super busy with work. So we have that. What else do we have? Oh, we have our high five promotion going on. If you guys got our email, then you know that yesterday was National High Five Day. And so we decided to do a high five special. So from now till the end of the month, if you use the code high five, you're gonna get a 5% discount on your orders that you place on our website. So make sure you check that out. And if you didn't get the email, make sure you're on our email list so that you don't miss any of those cool things that are coming. So let's get started because we've got a lot to do. Hey, Fee. Hey, Kim. All right, so I'm gonna tilt you down. And what we're gonna do first is we're gonna paint all the pieces to this box. We're gonna take it all apart and we're gonna paint all of its parts, front and back on some of them. And we're gonna start with white. And then I'm gonna use an antiquing wax to go over top of it to make it look distressed. For those of you who are used to watching me dry brush, it's very similar. We're just using a wax instead of a paint to do that. So I'm gonna paint all the parts first. And then while those are drying, we're gonna start working on our other project, which you're going to love. It is bee, beautiful. That always gives it away, right? It is bee related for my bee lovers. So we're just gonna put a coat on here. I'm super excited to make this shadow box. I have been playing with this file for a couple weeks, trying to decide how I wanted to do it, and this is just perfect. I hope everyone has had a good week and that you're gonna get some free time this weekend to do some fun things. It is absolutely gorgeous outside. Coming from a doctor's appointment, trying to decide whether I actually was gonna come back to work or whether I was gonna play hooky. And as you can see, I came back. I missed you though, Holly. I'm sorry I missed you. All right, get that front part done. And now on these pieces, all the side pieces, we're gonna have to do the front and the back because of course they're gonna show, which is not the norm for us. So We'll get the fronts done and let them dry a bit, and then I'll flip them over and do the backs. We're not used to people seeing the backs of our projects. And I think, Miss Lynn, that you may have gotten me tonight. Nope, my tape is still within reach. I have some letters to tape to paint, and I thought I had forgotten the tape, but I don't even have to get up to reach it, so I'm trying not to get caught without my painter's tape anymore. But I literally just got back here, so I may be a little discombobulated. Maybe, but we're gonna work it out. It's Friday. Anything goes on Friday, right? I am cutting some special projects this weekend too. So I literally cannot wait for the weekend, because I'm gonna show you guys some sneak peeks over the course of the weekend of next week's projects, which is always fun. I'm trying to get as many new projects out as I can while you still get that special, so you can save a little bit of money. All right, now on the front part where the chicken wire is, we're gonna be doing gray and white. So we're gonna have to use a smaller brush to do this side, so I don't get a bunch of mess. But I'm gonna do the white first so that if I go over, I can cover it up with my gray. I probably could just paint the whole thing white and then go over the gray, but I'm gonna try not to make a mess. Now remember, this is all gonna have antiquing wax on it too, so it's gonna have some brown to it to make it look old. And we'll see how that goes, because I have not made this yet. You guys are making it with me. And thank you guys. So many people have signed up for our Mason Jar virtual class. Oh my goodness. We are going to have so much fun. I love that Mason Jar. And I'm gonna leave mine out all year. As y'all saw, it's already on my mantle, and it's gonna find a place to be out all the time. It'd be pretty to paint your flowers really neutral, and then maybe add some buttons or something to it that you could change that would be seasonal. So you could paint your flowers yellow and put a pink center on them for the summer, and then change it to an orange center for the fall. Be super cute. I love to be able to use something for more than one purpose, as you guys know. All right, so let's paint these little chicken wire pieces with this elephant gray. And then we'll probably go back over them a bit with some silver. I don't want it to look too new though. This is a lot like the bathroom sign we did Wednesday night with the chicken wire. I'm on a chicken wire kick, apparently. Chicken wire and farmhouse just go together. This seems like it'll take forever, but it's really going along pretty quick. Pretty quick. You could use a Q-tip too to do this part. It would make it really easy. Just load the paint on your Q-tip and go across here. It'd be super fast. So we have set the dates for our kids club. So you will see some more information on that. It's going to be the first Saturday of the month, with the first one being May 1st. I think that's the first Saturday of the month. And I can't wait because it's an adorable project. You'll be able to sign up just like a regular event. And it'll be at 10 o'clock. So one Saturday a month, you got to bring the kiddos in and let them do a project that's just for them. And it'll be different every month. This month we're just offering, I think we're just offering one project. But what our goal is to be able to offer you several different options that you can choose from when you get here in case your child doesn't like the option that's available, even though you'll know in advance what it is. But if they change their mind when they get here, we'll have different options for them. And we're going to provide a snack and a drink. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Get them all geared up for our kids' camp this summer. All right, there we go. I think we got it. Except right there. Okay, so we're going to let these dry. Maybe I'll go over it really quick with the silver. Hey, Ashley. Hey, Tammy. Oh, yes, you do. She is going to love it. She will love it. Girl, she's like a crafter and a half. I'm going to do this while it's wet so that maybe it blends in a little more and doesn't feel quite so new. I'm using the same brush as well, so that helps to blend things out some. You can experiment with all kinds of techniques that way. And you can always paint over things, so don't be afraid to try something new. The worst that can happen is you have to paint over it. You might just discover something cool and new that you love to do, so don't be afraid of it. Ashley, did the boys nap all the way back to Fredericksburg? They had to be exhausted. They go 100 miles an hour. This is cute. I like this. All right. We're going to set all these pieces to the side and we are going to make our bee picture. Super, super cute. Oh, I got to paint the farmhouse. I got to paint the word farmhouse for this sign too. I'm telling you, leaving here in the middle of the day messes me all up. I don't know whether I'm coming or going right now. This is where the tape comes in. Technically, I didn't get all the way out of my chair. Miss Lynn is probably not even watching because Lynn got a big old box of goodies today. So she is probably painting her heart out right now. She doesn't even know if I use the tape or not. All right, let's tape this down. I'm going to own stock in 3M. And we are going to paint farmhouse. All right. Oh, he was talking. He had a lot to talk about, huh? Did y'all go to Blue Bear Gap Farm? You know what? I'm going to tell you what. When my kids were little, we practically lived at Blue Bear Gap Farm. My oldest loved to go to Blue Bear Gap Farm. We sometimes go there just to have lunch now, just to sit on the picnic tables and have lunch and watch the peacocks. All right, let's paint this farmhouse really quick, and then we'll start on the bee. That way, when we're done with the bee, we can whip this thing together and we're gonna have two finished projects that are amazing. I'm so excited to hang out with you guys this weekend too. I know so many of you are coming and I can't wait. I love crafting with y'all. And we are putting all the details together for our Palooza, which you know I love. We're gonna do one in June and one in July because we always sell out. The one in July will be a Christmas in July theme. So if you are a get it done quickly and soon kind of person, you might wanna do the Christmas in July one and get some Christmas things done. We did some cool projects last year for our Palooza that were Christmas related. And the one in June will be like a summer sizzler, so they will be all summer related projects. All right, I'm gonna set this aside and get started on the bee. Okay, so this bee is so cute. I love the hexagon shape, it makes me happy. It just lends itself to a bee, doesn't it? It's just kind of cool. The reason I moved in this direction is because I need to paint all of this black. And so I've already got the black out. So we will go ahead and do that. And then we'll move on to the other parts and then we'll just be putting it together. Super quick projects tonight. But I have not built the shadow box before, so I'm not gonna say quick projects yet. Not yet. I am gonna use the glue gun to put it together. At home, I don't recommend that. I still recommend using tacky glue. But in order to hold the project together and show you how to put it together, it needs to stick fast. And so I'm gonna use the glue gun for the purpose of showing you how to put it together. But at home, I still recommend tacky glue and just doing a section at a time. This is gonna be so cute. Just be happy. Be happy. It'd be even cuter if it was B-E-E instead of just B-E, but it's still cute. I'm excited for our mantle too on Monday. Oh my goodness, y'all. If you guys haven't been checking out our Make My Mantle Monday, you need to check it out. It's going to be hard to top the floral one from last week. I'm not going to lie, but I think I can do it. I think I can do it. All right, so that has to be black. And then our little bee guy here, he needs to have some black parts too. You know what I did? Let's see. You know what I did? I messed up. I messed up on this little guy. I didn't save his center pieces. All right, we'll wing it. We're going to wing it. He needs his center parts. Yours will have the center parts. Mine, we're going to wing it. He's just gonna have to be all black for now, but I have an idea of how to fix that. I got an idea. Yours will have his center parts though, so have no fear. I don't know how I missed that. Don't know how I missed that. They had a baby tortoise, are you kidding me? Hey, Michelle. Oh, another long list is coming. Yeah, it could be, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, ma'am. All right, so we've got those painted and I need to take my small brush and do the little stitching on this guy. I love these. I love when they have the little marks where they've been flying. So I'm gonna paint these in. You could use a paint pen as well, which I may resort to because this brush stinks. Let's see. Let's find a good one. Let's find a good one. I just love this weather. It's making me so happy. All right, this is a good one. I just feel it. Yeah. How stinking cute. Okay, so we'll let that dry. We got a lot of drying going on. Lots of drying going on. And now we're gonna paint, Now we're gonna paint the honeycomb part. And of course we're gonna use King's Gold for that because I love that for my beehive stuff. That's the color that I painted that Welcome to Our Hive as well. Love it. Okay, brushes. This may take a few minutes, but that's okay. No, I don't know. It'll go fast. This one just makes me happy. I can't wait to hang this one up. I got a lot of bee lovers out there too. And I understand why, because it is so happy. It's like sunflowers, right? It's just, bees are just happy. You can't not smile when you see bee decorations. It's impossible. So today on my way to work, my neighborhood is having a garage sale and a lot of people were doing it today. I never understand that. I guess it's retired people, right? Because who else can be off on a Friday to do a yard sale? But anyway, I picked up some pieces, oh my goodness, that I'm gonna make over and I can't wait to get started on those. So next week I'm gonna make those over. So make sure you check out our blog post on my repurposing because I bought some cool stuff that we're gonna redo. So you can read all of our past blogs too on our website. But this, I can't wait to write this one because I wanna do the project so bad. I try to write them while I'm doing the project so I don't forget anything. There's a process that goes along with this because I don't know about y'all, but once I make a project, I tend to forget how I did it. Does that happen to any of you? Honeycomb done. So now, make sure I got them the right way. We can't have our bee backwards. And happy in gray. And then we're done. Can you believe it? We just have to put these two projects together. And that'll be a wrap for this Friday Night Live. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. It went so fast. Well, I'm not gonna say that. That little shadow box is not gonna be a 5-minute job, I don't think. I promise not to say any curse words, Ashley. My virtual assistant probably cringes every time I go live, but I promise, no matter how hard it is, I won't say any curse words. I'm working on it. If you ever really want to hear me curse, though, let me try to put something together that I can't put together. Oh my goodness. Whew. I'm not a good builder of things like, well, particularly IKEA things. Just for the record, if any of you are good at building IKEA things, I can't be friends with you. Because holy cow, they're like 5 bazillion pieces. The directions are at best. I don't even understand it. So I'm not good at putting things together. It's not my forte. Crafting wise it is, but building things, no. Not things that I didn't design. I can build something that I completely designed, but. So those of you who are good at like bringing a box home from the store and putting it together, more power to you. I need your name and number because if I need to put something together, I'm gonna need to call you. These bookcases behind me, holy cow. Of course, they didn't come with their instructions. So that was fun. All right, we got that all done. Got got it all together here. What I didn't do is grab my glue.
I will. I remembered the tape, forgot the glue. There's always something, right?
There's always one thing that I forget. It's gonna happen. It's a given. Okay, so let's start putting this bee together because I think all of his parts are dry enough for us to glue together. This is so much fun. I can't wait to see it together. Oh, it will go good in the bathroom. I always forget your bathroom is bees. All right, so let's start putting this puppy together. So we know that this little honeycomb is gonna go down here. And then this sits right above it in those points. So I'm gonna glue down this piece first, right in its points, so that we have a baseline for where everything else goes. Because no, Dawn, this one does not have any guidelines on it. But you won't need them. Everything's pretty, pretty easily laid out on this one. There's no room for things to go anywhere else. All right. Just line it up in the points. Just like that. Some glue on our honeycomb. You don't have to put glue everywhere, just hit the high points. Tacky glue is good stuff, so you don't need a ton of it. Once it's on there, it's not coming off. Believe me, I made a boo-boo on a project last week and I had to just start over because that glue was not coming off. Oh my goodness, y'all. This is so cute. Okay, now we'll glue on our bee. Be happy. For those of you who did the bee tiered tray set, you need this one. Or the Welcome to My Hive. That's one of our all-time favorite ones, is the Welcome to Our Hive. I thought that one was adorable. Oh, this is sweet. I like this a lot. I like this a lot. And then we're gonna glue this right there so it hangs off onto the honeycomb section. So stinking cute. Oh my goodness. I love it. Now this piece, gotta have all the layers to make it look finished. I know y'all get your boxes sometimes and think, what in the world do I do with all these pieces? There we go. Oh, I love how that's offset so you can see the white underneath it on the edges. I love that. Love it. All right, and now this fun guy, who of course needs his yellow. So what I'm gonna do, since I left mine pieces off, you will have your pieces, is I am going to take my yellow and I'm gonna paint in those little sections just so you can see it. So he has his parts the way they're supposed to be. So I'm just gonna paint yellow in there. Just so he looks like he's supposed to. You won't have to do this because you'll have the wood pieces that go in there. I think I probably took them off the laser and thought they were part of the trash pile. All right, that's adorable. Adorbs. Okay, but I am also gonna take my white. Give him a little shadow in there for his wings. Just dry brush a little on there. He's so cute. Oh my goodness. That's one cutie pie bee. All right, there you go, guys. That one is all finished. Look how adorable that is. Oh my gosh. I love it. I love it. Super, super sweet project. That one is a keeper. I like it. All right, so here's where we are. We're getting ready to put this box together. But first, we are going to put some antiquing wax on it. So if you haven't used antiquing wax, I picked this one up on clearance at Michael's. It's Craft Smart brand. You generally put it over a paint finish to make it look old. That's the general idea. And that is exactly what we're gonna do with it. We did not paint the backs of our project. So what I'm gonna do is after it's all put together, I'm gonna paint the backs. So you guys don't have to watch paint dry anymore. Hey, Jennifer. So I'm gonna use a chip brush and some paper towels just to give it that finish to make it look old and antiqued. I'm gonna show you on one of these pieces first. So I'm just gonna get a little bit of this antiquing wax on my brush and wipe some of it off. And then I'm just gonna rub it on like this. What I'm going for is old wood. And I'm getting exactly what I wanted. I'm gonna do the same thing on here. And once I have them the way I want them, I'm gonna wipe it off a little bit so that it looks like it is worn into the wood. I want this to look like this box has been around forever. See, when you rub it, it goes into that white and it looks like it's chipped off white paint rather than stain on top of the wood. You see how that looks? Super, super cool. This is a lot of fun. It gives a nice finish. It's a nice way to quickly age something. I'm gonna go around these edges as well. Get a little bit more on my brush. Ooh, not that much. But I love the way it looks so much that I am gonna do the same technique. And it'll pop nice with our black farmhouse that's gonna go inside of there. Just rub it down so it looks like it's part of the paint. Now, we gotta let this hot glue gun heat up. So what's gonna happen is we're gonna glue the farmhouse words on while we wait for that, and then we're gonna start putting this box together. Now, I'm not gonna glue the last end of my box together because I think, hey, Maddie, I think I'm gonna put some floral in mine. But I'm not sure yet what I wanna put in it, so I'm not putting anything yet until I figure out what I want. You could leave your end not glued, and then you could change whatever you put inside out for the seasons, which would be cool. Or you could just put nothing in it, and that would be cute too. Okay, I like that. Start gluing. I'm just dipping my letters into the paint. So much easier. This is so cute. You can tell I love both projects tonight. That doesn't always happen. I always like all the projects, but sometimes I really love the projects. And tonight I really love both of them. Okay, so this is how it's gonna start. We're gonna have to glue these pieces together like this to form the box. So I am, as soon as this glue gun is ready, gonna put little dabs of glue in here. Again, at home, I really recommend using your tacky glue, but for the sake of time, we're going to do it this way. So these pieces will all go together like this. And then we'll put our side pieces on, and then we'll put our top on. But again, I'm not gonna glue that end because I'm gonna put floral in mine. So I'm gonna glue the three pieces around and the top on, but I'm just gonna push in the last part. This is gonna be gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. We are just waiting for this glue gun. I did not turn it on fast enough, apparently. I just love how that turned out. This really looks like an old piece of chicken wire with a wood frame on it, which is super cool. You could leave the farmhouse words off of it and put something else in it would be very cool as well. If you wanted to fill it with some treasures, that would be cool. I think that's it. I can't help it. I keep looking at this. It's so cute. I love it. This reminds me of the laundry room one we did with these layers. I love that. It's got the same bulk to it as well. Super, super cute. Super cute. And don't forget about these keychains. If you got a mama in your life, I know she would love these, especially if you're that kind human that she's raising. All right. Let's see if this glue gun's ready for me. Because I don't want big mounds of glue. We don't want that at all. Because we need it to be flush in there. So I'm going to stick that one in and see how we did. To use some more. We may have to put some more on that one. I don't think I got enough. Nope, definitely didn't get enough. It's coming apart like that. This is why patience and tacky glue is always a hit. Just let this set up for a second. It definitely is very sturdy once you have all of its parts together because they all work off of each other. So we're gonna set that up. Do this again. Get some of that glue out. And I'm going to turn it around for you in just a second so you can see how it looks as you're putting it together. I just cannot work backwards. And I have the big battery on my glue gun, so it's like super heavy. Super heavy. There we go. So see, we're going to paint these back sides, which we should have done before we started, but that's okay. It'll all work just as well. So now you can see how it's starting to come together into its box. It says farmhouse. Yes, it says farmhouse. Hey, Lynn. Oh, you are watching. I thought you were going to be working on your stuff. I didn't think you were going to catch us tonight. You almost caught me without my tape. I think I'm gluing myself to the table. Kind of. I kind of am. No curse words, Kim. No curse words. I got too much glue on that one, and now it's got too much buildup. This is why tacky glue is best. It is best. Okay. One more try at this. Woo! Too much. This is why you don't want the hot glue, for sure. So I don't think it's going to fit in now. It's got too much glue. Too much glue. Let's try it this way. Let's try it this way. There we go. All right. Just going to hold it for a minute. This is going to be so cute. So, so cute. Like building a puzzle. You just have to slide them in. And they form the box. This is so hard to do backwards. I'm not even going to lie to you. And stuck to the table. All right, here we go. Tuck these clips in where they go, like that. You will be gluing yours. I'm just not gluing mine right now. I'm just trying to get it together so you can see it. Because it goes together much easier when you're not on camera. Okay, there we go. I'm scared to take it back off and glue it. Do those. That'll keep it together. And just hold it till it sets up really well. And then I'm going to show you the last piece. Oh, you're working, working. Okay. Hey, Tiffany, you're not playing, you're working. All right, now the last piece. Get all my little, this is the other reason you don't want to use hot glue, is because of all the little glue drips. You don't want glue drips on your project. All right, so then the last piece goes in on the top, and you'll be gluing this down if you want, or you can leave it. I'm going to leave mine because I am going to put flowers in it later. But here is what the finished project looks like. Holy cow, is that gorgeous. It really looks like chicken wire, too. That's so super cool. I absolutely love this. So I'm going to go over everything with white around these edges so that you don't see the seams. And you can do that with a small white brush. You could also paint those while we were painting. We could have painted those edges. I didn't even think about it, so that everything lined up white when you put it together. But I kind of like that because it looks like old tongue and groove, like it was put together like that. This is super cool. This, I don't know, the bee project is cool, but this one may take the cake. I love the farmhouse shadow box. And like I said, you can put greenery down at the bottom. You could leave farmhouse off and put something in it. It'd be really cool if you glued farmhouse on top and then put greenery inside the shadow box. There's a million ways that you could work with the shadow box. This is very, very cool. So the shadow box tonight and the Be Happy are our projects. We did a super fantastic job. That was quick, even with the box debacle. It really goes together easy, I promise you. Just use tacky glue, don't use hot glue. And don't forget about our cool projects. I'll tilt you back up so you don't have to look at the tablecloth. Cool projects this weekend. I think the crab's my favorite, but you all know I love starfish. So you've got these welcome signs that we have this weekend. And then, of course, the ocean wave heart, which is gorgeous. So I hope you guys will come out and hang out with us. If you order kits this evening, if you do it by midnight, I can have them ready for you tomorrow to pick up or to do here in the shop. So I hope you guys will come and hang out with us and have a great weekend. Bye.